Hello, students, and welcome back to our exciting journey through the world of carbohydrates. Today's topic, monosaccharides. In this episode, we're going to delve even deeper into the world of carbohydrates, exploring new concepts and building upon the knowledge we've gained in previous episodes. But before we dive in, let's quickly recap what we've learned so far. In previous episodes, we've covered the basics of carbohydrates, their structure, and their importance in biology and nutrition. We've discovered how carbohydrates provide energy, and we've explored the fascinating world of monosaccharides, disaccharides, and polysaccharides. In this video, the concepts and learning outcomes provide a solid foundation for understanding the structure, properties, and importance of monosaccharides within the broader context of carbohydrates. Monosaccharides are the simplest form of carbohydrates, often referred to as simple sugars. They are organic compounds consisting of a single sugar molecule and are composed of carbon, C, hydrogen, H, and oxygen, O, atoms. Monosaccharides are the building blocks of more complex carbohydrates and serve as a primary source of energy in biological systems. Monosaccharides are the most basic unit of carbohydrates, containing a single sugar molecule. They have the general chemical formula, CH2ON, where N represents the number of carbon atoms in the molecule. Monosaccharides are typically classified based on the number of carbon atoms they contain, such as trioses, 3 carbons, tetrases, 4 carbons, pentoses, 5 carbons, and hexoses, 6 carbons. Hexoses are the most common monosaccharides in biology. Some common examples of hexoses 6 carbon monosaccharides: glucose, fructose, and galactose. Glucose. Glucose is a fundamental monosaccharide and is often referred to as blood sugar. It is a primary source of energy in cells and plays a central role in cellular respiration. Fructose. Fructose is a sweet-tasting monosaccharide found in fruits and honey. It is commonly used as a sweetener in the food industry. Galactose. Galactose is found in milk and dairy products. It is less sweet than glucose and fructose but still serves as an energy source.
Monosaccharides can exist in various structural forms, including linear and cyclic configurations. They can also differ in the arrangement of their functional groups, such as the presence of aldehyde or ketone groups. Most common hexoses, glucose and fructose, have different structural isomers. These simple sugars are essential for various biological processes, including energy production, synthesis of more complex carbohydrates, and formation of structural components in living organisms. Structure and isomerism. In monosaccharides, aldoses and ketoses. Monosaccharides, simplest form of carbohydrates, can exhibit structural and stereochemical isomerism. Structural isomerism refers to different structural arrangements of same molecular formula, while stereochemical isomerism involves differences in the spatial arrangement of atoms within a molecule. In the case of monosaccharides, isomerism is categorized into two main types, aldoses and ketoses. Aldoses are monosaccharides that contain an aldehyde functional group. CHO are typically composed of a carbon chain with 3 or more carbon atoms. The carbonyl group CHO is found at one end of carbon chain. Aldose can be further classified based on number of carbon atoms in the molecule. 3 carbon aldose is called triose. Example glyceraldehyde, a 4 carbon aldose is called a tetrose, example erythrose, and so on. The structural isomerism in aldoses arises from differences in the arrangement of atoms around the carbon atoms, especially the position of the hydroxyl OH groups. This result in different aldose isomers with same molecular formula. 4 possible stereoisomers from 2 pairs of enantiomers, 2 squared equals 4, 8 possible stereoisomers from 3 pairs of enantiomers, 2 cubed equals 8, 16 possible stereoisomers from 4 pairs of enantiomers, 2 to the power of 4 equals 16.
Ketoses. Ketoses are monosaccharides that contain a ketone functional group, C double bond O, and are also typically composed of a carbon chain with 3 or more carbon atoms. The carbonyl group, C double bond O, is located within the carbon chain, not at the ends. As with aldoses, ketoses can be classified based on the number of carbon atoms. For example, a 3 carbon ketose is called a triose, for example, dihydroxyacetone, a 4 carbon ketose is called a tetrose, for example, erythriolose, and so on. Ketoses also exhibit structural isomerism due to differences in the arrangement of atoms around the carbon atoms, particularly the positions of the hydroxyl, OH, groups. Now it is important to understand stereoisomerism or chirality in monosaccharides. Stereoisomerism, chirality. Both aldoses and ketoses can exhibit stereochemical isomerism, which results from the spatial arrangement of atoms. Monosaccharides often have multiple chiral centers, carbon atoms bonded to four different groups, and the arrangement of these chiral centers can give rise to various stereoisomers. The most well-known example of stereoisomerism in monosaccharides is the formation of enantiomers, such as D-glucose and L-glucose. These enantiomers have the same molecular formula and structural arrangement but differ in their three-dimensional orientation, leading to different optical properties. Therefore, we can say that monosaccharides, whether they are aldoses or ketoses, can exhibit structural and stereochemical isomerism due to differences in the arrangement of atoms and chiral centers within their molecular structures. These isomerism contribute to the diversity of sugars found in nature. Fischer projection versus Haworth projection. Fischer projection is a 2D representation of an organic molecule by projection, while Haworth projection is a way of drawing the structure of an organic molecule representing the cyclic structure of monosaccharides in a 3D perspective. Examples of both Fischer and Haworth projections for a common monosaccharide, D-glucose. D-glucose is a hexose sugar, and its structure can be represented in both Fischer and Haworth projections. Fischer projection, the vertical lines represent bonds coming out of the plane of the paper, wedges, and the horizontal lines represent bonds going into the plane of the paper, dashes. The chiral carbon, the carbon atom bonded to four different groups, is typically represented as a cross, plus. D-glucose has four chiral carbons. Haworth projection, the sugar ring is shown as a hexagon, representing the six carbon atoms in the ring. The positions of substituents OH groups are indicated as either above or below the plane of the ring. In this example, it's beta D-glucose, where the OH group on the anomeric carbon, C1, points up, above the plane of the ring. Cyclic structure in monosaccharides. Cyclic structures of monosaccharides are formed through intramolecular reactions involving the carbonyl group, either an aldehyde or a ketone group, and hydroxyl groups within the same sugar molecule. Hemiacetal. Monosaccharide has an aldehyde group. In the case of aldose monosaccharides, it can react with a hydroxyl group on another carbon atom within the same molecule. This intramolecular reaction forms a ring structure, specifically a hemiacetal. The reaction involves the carbonyl group C double bond O of the aldehyde and an adjacent hydroxyl group OH, resulting in the formation of a new oxygen bridge, creating a stable, cyclic ring. Hemiketals. In the case of ketose monosaccharides, those containing a ketone group, the same principle applies. The ketone group reacts with a hydroxyl group on another carbon atom, forming a ring structure known as a hemiketal. Anomers and mutarotation in monosaccharides. Two cyclic stereoisomers can form from each straight-chain monosaccharide, these are known as anomers. The two forms of anomers are typically denoted as alpha and beta. Alpha anomer, in the alpha anomer, the hydroxyl, O, group at the anomeric carbon is oriented below the plane of the ring. Beta anomer, in the beta anomer, the hydroxyl group at the anomeric carbon is oriented above the plane of the ring. In an aqueous solution, monosaccharides exist as an equilibrium mixture forms between the two anomers and the straight chain structure of a monosaccharide in a process known as mutarotation. When a monosaccharide is dissolved in water, it can interconvert between its alpha and beta anomers due to the breaking and reforming of the covalent bonds involved in the ring structure.
Thanks for watching. Coming up next.